I'm good with the cards. I could have been a lover, breaking others' hearts. And I feel so silly, betting on the dice. And a lover seldom see the same girl twice. And that is why,
that is why.
Oh, that's why I chose.
That's why I chose.
I chose the same girl blue. Yes, I did.
Hey, welcome back to the Man Cave Cigar Lounge. I'm Clint Denny with my host, as always, is beautiful Jill Morell.
Hey, guys.
Today we are going to be reviewing the Camacho Shellback. This is a limited edition release that Camacho has done this year. It's the second in what they refer to as their Brotherhood series. This particular cigar is called the Shellback for one very simple reason. Fortune favors the bold. And the shellback is a Navy term where anytime a sailor crossed the equator, they were given a new name from a polywog to a shellback. And it meant that they had joined the Sons of Neptune and gone on to fight the greater fight. If you look at the band on it, it's got the normal Camacho Scorpion, and it has the Neptune Trident on it as well. If you look at the larger band, it's all done in lime green. It's got the normal Camacho banding on it. Says Brotherhood Series. Our Brotherhood Series crosses the line from bold to fearless. Is what's printed on the band with, again, the Scorpion and the Trident. It's in a lime green color, and it's excellent. The labeling on this is gorgeous. It has some lines, like if you were looking at Navy maps on there. It's really nice. So, for today's review of this cigar, I've decided to do something a little different. This is a very limited edition release by Camacho, and we just got these in the shop just a couple of days ago. Jill was actually lucky enough to come in when we got them, get one of the cigars, and smoke it.
I didn't want to wait for these. We talked about them in our previous review on Camacho, and as soon as they came in, I had to get myself one, and I'm happy I did.
Awesome. Well, we got several things in, and so I knew that I wanted to smoke this. I've heard nothing but great things about it, but I decided to wait. And so I'm actually have read nothing about the cigar. I haven't done any reviews. I haven't looked at anything, and I haven't smoked it yet. So I have no idea what this cigar is going to taste like. I've heard some different things from different people. Nothing generally actually reviewing the cigar. But what it is it is a Ecuadorian Habano wrapper with a Nicaraguan binder and Nicaraguan filler. So I've already taken mine out of the cellophane, as Jill has as well. And as I look at it, it's really beautiful chocolatey cocoa brown color. The veins on it are really, really pronounced. You can definitely see where it was a very beautiful leaf at one time. I'm noting where the cap was put on. I don't know if it's a construction issue or maybe not enough glue, or maybe the cap was cut a little too small. There's a little bit of inconsistency on the top of the cap, which usually probably won't be much of a problem. So I'm going to take the it has a beautiful footband. The art on this cigar is just amazing. They did a really great job with this.
And we've talked about this before. I love the bright colors. I like something that's going to stand out, and as soon as I see it, my eye is drawn to it. And Camacho has done a great job of doing that for me with their bold colors.
This particular cigar, the footband, which unlike some other brands of cigars, the footband just slides right off real easy. I thought I was going to have to peel it off, but it came right off. Looking at the foot of the cigar, perfect cut across there. It looks like the cigar was constructed very well. So I'm going to cut. Also, we are drinking, I'm drinking coffee this morning, and Jill is drinking a peach pie tea of some type that we got from the Man Cave Cafe. Yes, of course, we're a full service Man Cave. So even with a little bit of inconsistency on the cap, it cut perfectly above the shoulder, so there's no problems. Perfect draw. I'm not getting any really notes of anything through the draw. Sometimes you'll get a more of a cocoa note or something like that, but I'm just getting a perfect draw. So let's toast and see what we get. Loom tabletop lighters from Zycar.
I as well am using a Zycar dual flame. I love the draw on this. This cigar is rolled.
It is a perfect draw. Perfect draw. I'm getting a really good thick smoke.
This is a great cigar.
So in the beginning I'm getting a little bit of spice. I'm definitely getting a little bit of oakiness to it, earthy notes. In the beginning, it doesn't seem to be too complex. It's kind of straightforward, but of course I've just lit it, so that probably will change here in just a couple of minutes.
I love the earthiness of this cigar. It reminds me of eating mushrooms or something just very earthy and woodsy, and it's got that great profile to it.
So it definitely has a hint of spice. The spice is kind of going away, and I take that probably from the initial lighting. So something else is coming through. It's almost a bit of citrus that I'm getting out of it.
I'm noticing a little bit of sweetness. And that could be from the Habano wrapper.
It could. Yeah, definitely you will. There's something else in there I can't note. And of course, We're both drinking coffee and tea, so that can make a difference on your palate as well. For me, I enjoy coffee with a cigar.
And I personally enjoy a nice glass of red wine with mine.
It's never too early for red wine.
Nope, it's a great after getting off work and enjoy a cigar and a glass of Merlot.
All right, so I'm definitely getting some sweetness now. I'm almost getting the whatever I was getting of the citrusy is really not there. It's more of a, what I was saying earlier was wrong, and the complexity in the beginning was just the way it started off, but it's definitely changing a lot, the cigars.
You are in for a treat with this one, because I did notice quite a few flavor changes throughout the cigar, and it kind of takes you by surprise, but it's a really good surprise.
And you know, you mentioned the flavor changes, and to each his own when it comes to a palate, and how we taste our cigars. Some people will smoke a cigar and they'll get a great complexity throughout the cigar, flavor changes up and down, left and right, back and forth. Some people can smoke the same cigar and just taste what the cigar tastes like. I am noticing that I'm getting a little bit of a run. It's not too bad.
Mine's not, you know, perfectly even all the way around, but mine is holding pretty well. It's not canoeing or tunneling or anything like that, but it is doing really well, even though it is a bit uneven.
I will say that Camacho as a whole puts a lot of pride into their product, not just the cigars. And even though I'm getting an uneven burn on the cigar, don't let that deter you from the cigar. Cigars are a handmade, premium product. There's going to be imperfections. It just happens. Anytime you buy something handmade, something can be, one wrapper is rolled a little tighter than the next, and even though they're usually very, very consistent, things happen. But not only in their pride in their cigars, but pride in the labeling of the cigars, pride in the cigar bands. Maybe you look at this, just the detail, the craftsmanship and the artwork. Also on the boxes. Camacho's boxes are just really top notch.
They're beautiful.
They are. The core series with the lacquered boxes and a lot of theirs, even from some of the other lines, are lacquered and look really nice. This one from the Brotherhood series, if you can see, it actually has a functioning compass that they've built onto it. And it's the design of it, the colors are really nice. I will say the only thing I didn't like about this box is I noticed when we were putting them on the shelves, cigar boxes, for the most part, are flat. And so with this one having about a quarter inch raised or quarter to half inch raised compass in it, made it very difficult to set the cigar boxes on top of each other. But other than that, it's really a phenomenal product. We've had several people already ask us, hey, can we have that box? Can we have that box?
I might be one of those people.
So I'm getting a little more of a canoe here. It's not canoeing really bad, but it's definitely, one side is definitely burning quite a bit faster than the other. I'm going to do a touch up here in just a second, see how that does, and we're going to smoke down a little further, and we'll be right back. Touched up the cigar a little bit, and one of the things I noticed was after smoking it for about 10 minutes or so, it's doing the exact same thing on the exact same side of the cigar. And I've talked about this before in previous videos. A lot of times that is the binder rolled over and doubled on one side or not going around. The wrapper looks perfect. It actually looks like the wrapper is beautiful. So it tends to, there's several different things that can happen that can make a cigar do this. Could be that it's a little loosely packed in there on one side so that that side's burning. Could be the binder is not properly done 100%. There's different things. But what I will say is the cigar is delicious. It has changed flavors through it a couple times. Now her cigar I'm looking at is keeping pretty straight. There's a little bit of an angle to it.
Right.
Not much, but it's not anywhere near as pronounced. Mine's probably actually burning on about a 45 degree angle right now.
And that's the thing about the hand rolled cigars, you know, that we had already mentioned. You know, these are not some cookie cutter done in a huge factory with machines. These are individual people actually rolling these cigars. So every once in a while you'll get one that will canoe just a little bit. But Camacho does a good job of trying to keep their quality very high. And, you know, and every once in a while you just get one that has a little bit of an issue, but the flavor is still definitely there. And it is really, really worth the purchase, the cigar.
The sweetness of the cigar is really staying with it. I'm definitely getting, the sweetness that I'm getting is like a graham cracker sweetness. It's not that chocolatey or cocoa sweetness, but it's more like a graham cracker. Not just overpowering in your face, like infused or anything. And it's funny when you talk about cigars and you'll say, oh, I can taste the sweetness to it or an oakiness. Especially for new cigar smokers, they're like, what are you talking about? And they automatically assume that it's like a infused cigar, like infused with chocolate or coffee, or, you know, because there's so many cigars that are infused with so many things, and so many of them, like some of the companies won't even tell you what they're infused with or what their flavor is trying to be, that they think you're talking about that, and you have to explain to them, no, there are infused cigars that are sweet and taste like chocolate, but these are actually the notes that you get on your palate.
Yeah, I smoked a few flavored cigars when I first began smoking, like most women do, and I personally did not care for the cigars that were infused with a ton of flavor. I prefer more natural tobacco flavor and something that's a little bit more mellow in taste, and this cigar hits all of those points. It has the sweetness. It still has a little bit of spice, but it's still very mellow and very natural.
If you can see the look on my face, you can probably see the eye rolling and the Jill, you're full of it looks, because I've seen this girl sit back in the back to do homework and she's smoking cigars that would make some men gag because they're so strong. And I know they're that strong because I've smoked them. So her palate and her preference ranges from mellow, as she says, to there's some that are bold and spicy, and we've said, hey, this is full of spice, but we're going to review it. And she just jumps on it like crazy. So she say she's just a mellow girl is a mellow understatement.
It all depends on the mood. Like most ladies, you know, I have different moods and different flavors that I prefer.
You mean you change your mind about things? Who would have thought?
I know. But I'll in one day, I'll go from something very mellow to something very strong in the afternoon, and it's a nice progression. And so this, for me, is a perfect beginning of the day cigar, or maybe even, you know, cigar number two or three on a day that I'm smoking four or five, because I've got three papers due at midnight. And so this is a good...
And it's the only way to get it through. So after touching up the back of the cigar, it has lined out. One of the things also you can do with cigars, that's what a lighter's for, is if you need to do a minor touch-up, sometimes that will do it. But if you lay your cigar in the ashtray with the tunnel or the canoeing face down, like if the cigar is canoeing this way, you lay it down like this, less air actually gets to it, more air gets to the top, and so the top will burn faster to try and help catch up that canoeing. So we're going to smoke these down. The second, third, really great, getting more of that graham crackerness. We're going to smoke these down a little further, and we'll be back in a few minutes. All right, so I will say that this cigar has, since I touched it up a little bit, whatever the problem was beforehand has really gotten into staying razor sharp on the burn. And the flavor has changed. The flavor of this cigar has mellowed a little bit, but surprisingly, with the mellowing, I'm getting a little more spice to it.
I'm also getting that same spice, but just as yours has evened out and you have that razor sharp burn, I am now having a little bit more of a canoeing issue, though. However, it's not very bad, and I'm enjoying that flavor change and that mellowing of the cigar. For me, when I'm smoking my first or second cigar of the day, I prefer the mellow. So this is definitely right up my alley with the flavor profile here.
Awesome. So now I'm going to do the one thing that always amazes me with different cigars. I'm going to take the band off. And some cigars you've seen us, we have to fight with the band, or there's enough glue to glue a house together. So let's see just how easily this thing comes off. Super smooth. Looks like they just put a little bit of glue on the back. The wrapper goes all the way around. It's probably got 3/4 of an inch between one end of the wrapper that files away. And to take it off, my favorite thing, no glue whatsoever on the wrapper itself, and that happens more often than not. It seems like whoever makes it, let's get it on. And a lot of people, when they get down that far with the cigar, they're ready to put it out anyway a lot of times. And then there's people like Jill and I that, you know, we need a toothpick to finish this cigar.
For me, once it starts to burn my fingers, and I mean really burn my fingers, that's when it's time for me to put it out. So I try to get it down to where it's still about an inch and a half, and then I'm, you know, about to cringe because I'm done with my cigar, and it's time to grab a second one.
It's an easy thing to do.
Yeah.
You know, and I'll say one thing that's far and few between for me is to smoke the same cigar back to back. I've noticed that when you're in the shop, you usually don't do that either. You usually grab something else and change your palate up a little bit. I will say this is it's definitely a medium to full. This is definitely not something you want to smoke first thing in the morning with just a cup of coffee like I'm doing right now. But I smoke strong cigars all the time. But for somebody that likes a nice milder cigar, this would be your lunchtime. Start out around lunch, or if you aren't a huge full body flavor cigar smoker, then you would want to save this for the evening. But it's definitely a great cigar. I would really say that I can see this pairing well with red wine. I'm not a huge red wine drinker, but the flavors that are coming through. The sweetness of the cigar is pretty much left. I'm not getting any more of that at all. I'm getting some grassy notes and a little more earthiness. I got that oak in the beginning and it kind of went away, and the graham crackeriness took over the sweetness. Now I'm getting back into some earthy.
I'm also getting that earthiness, but I'm still getting a little bit of that spice to it that I like. It's just that little bit of tingle on the back of my throat that just kind of perks me up a little bit.
On the retrohale, there's a moderate amount of spice. It's not overpowering, but it is. It's like you said, it's just a tingle. It's not, I wouldn't even say black pepper, more like a light white pepper to it. You know, something that's not just going to knock you flat or say, yeah, I don't want to smoke that.
Right.
And to each his own, everyone has different palates. And some people are like, I want no spice in the cigar whatsoever. Some people want a cigar that stays the same consistently. Some people want it to change. It's up to you how you enjoy your cigar.
For me, smoking a cigar is like a little adventure. I like to be surprised by the cigar. I like to have a general idea of what kind of cigar it's going to be. But as I smoke it, I really enjoy the cigars that intrigue me, or that I'm getting a flavor or a note that I can't quite understand, and I have to smoke it a little bit more to fully grasp what flavor I'm getting. And this cigar does that for me. It gives me that variety. It keeps me guessing as to what flavor I'm going to get next, just because it does change. And to me, that's great. It's a little adventure in my mouth.
Awesome. Well, we're getting down to the end of these. This has been a great cigar. At this last third or so, I don't see that it's probably going to change too much more. We're fixing to cut short here in just a moment and let y'all go out, pick up a few cigars, watch the video. One of my favorite things to do is grab the tablet, go on the back porch, watch a few YouTube videos, and drink a cup of coffee and have a cigar. This has been a very enjoyable cigar, and I compliment Camacho for what they've done. This is a limited edition cigar. There's not a lot out there. They are in stores now. I definitely recommend that you pick up this cigar. It's a really, really great cigar, and I think you will really, really be pleased with the cigar after you smoke it. Again, this is Clint and Jill from the Man Cave Cigar Lounge. Thank you for joining us, and we will see you next time.
Have a good night.